The bright light for courage in the darkest night. I read through the pages of your letters, the grandfather I never knew, trying to translate your words into this language, where your beloved children and people found refuge after the terrible war, where a third of our men perished, and where you too died a death too horrible for your enemies to ever brag about. Testing each word, each comma, each period, each space, I can go so deep into your inner thoughts, sweetest dreams, greatest disappointments, all the things you said, and even those that you did not mean to say. I try to stay true to what you meant to say, interpret what you left unsaid, and respect what can never be said. Line by line, I learned the man you were, the story of our family, the history of a country that should have been mine. I can even taste the rice and bananas and mangoes that my grandmother planted with her own hands on the land that she bought for my father with the precious money he saved from his scholarship. His dream of coming back after school and live close to his parents, you would have been proud and probably a little bit sad to know he did remain the kind of man happy to buy $2 shoes to save more for his family. As yes, life was hard after losing you, his country, and feeling so heartbroken about both. But everyone had to become a survivor. As the final pages arrive always too soon, it gets harder and harder to read them, knowing the ending is also already written, and that it can never change, no matter how many times I edit it or read it. I worry a little that other people will not understand or will maliciously misinterpret your final actions, the dangerous and painful peacemaking missions that no one else would take, convincing Royal Army Hmong soldiers, CIA secret army soldiers left behind to surrender instead of being massacred, or stopping the too visible flight of masses scared of the communists that the new regime was going to shoot down. Will they see how great your heart was and how strong your courage was to accept that ungrateful work because you could save so many lives of Hmong people? They who you loved even more than your own life or your family? Coming to your last page and reading your last words, I feel both relieved and quietly sad. They still carry only your hopes of peace and nothing of your darkest days, just the bright light that will give us the courage to live well, your deepest desire.